We gather as the people of God to be fed by God's word in the Holy Scriptures and by Jesus' body and blood in the Holy Eucharist. We extend a special welcome to any visitors who have joined us for our celebration. We respectfully ask that you please place your cell phones in the off position during this time of prayer. Today we celebrate the 26th Sunday in Ordinary Times. The scripture readings for the Mass today can be found on page 56 in your Missal. Today's second collection is for the special Haiti Disaster Relief Fund. Thank you for your continued generosity as we try to help our less fortunate brothers and sisters throughout the world. As we gather for Mass, please join me in saying our parish prayer located on the inside cover of our songbooks. Let us pray. Soul of Jesus, sanctify me. Body of Jesus, fill me. Blood of Jesus, fill me. Water of Jesus, die, wash me. Passion of Jesus, strengthen me. Within your holy wounds, shelter me. To the service of my neighbors, draw me. To become a more authentic Christian, transform me. Holy Spirit, guide me. At the moment of my death, call me. That we, saints, forever and ever. Amen. Our gathering song is Open the Eyes of My Heart. It is number 93 in the Inspirational Songbook. Please stand as we welcome our celebrant, Father Mario.
People of goodwill, we praise you. bless you. We adore you. We glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who manifests your almighty power, above all by pardoning and showing mercy, bestow, we pray, your grace abundantly upon us, and make those hastening to attain your promises heirs to the treasures of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Numbers. The Lord came down in the cloud and spoke to Moses. Taking some of the spirit that was on Moses, the Lord bestowed it on the 70 elders. And as the spirit came to rest on them, they prophesied. Now two men, one named Eldad and the other Medad, were not in the gathering, but had been left in the camp. They too had been on the list, but had not gone out to the tent. Yet the Spirit came to rest on them also, and they prophesied in the camp. So when a young man quickly told Moses, "Eldad and Medad are prophesying in the camp," Joshua, son of Nun, who from his youth had been Moses' aide, said, "Moses, my lord, stop them." But Moses answered him, "Are you jealous for my sake? Would that all the people of the Lord were prophets. Would that the Lord might bestow his spirit on them all." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart.
A reading from the letter of St. James. Come now, you rich, weep and wail over your impending miseries. Your wealth has rotted away. Your clothes have become moth-eaten. Your gold and silver have corroded, and that corrosion will be a testimony against you. It will devour your flesh like a fire. You have stored up treasure for the last days. Behold, the wages you withheld from the workers who have harvested your fields are crying aloud. And the cries of the harvesters have reached the ears of the Lord of hosts. You have lived on earth in luxury and pleasure. You have fattened your hearts for the day of slaughter. You have condemned. You have murdered the righteous one. He offers you no resistance. The word of the Lord.
If I told this story before, I don't remember if I did or not. Give me the cut sign if you've already heard it. My first assignment as a priest was in Crowley at St. Michael's Church. And as a newly ordained priest, I was certainly green behind the ears and was just trying to learn and to meet people. And on the staff, the secretary there is named Rose. And Rose has been there many, many years. I think she recently passed away, but a wonderful person, very friendly, very encouraging, and would really just encourage me as a rookie priest. And so I got to be friends with Rose, and every now and then we'd play little jokes on one another. And I think it was probably in October. I know it was getting chilly, getting cooler outside. And it must have been near Halloween in that area. Somehow I came across, somebody gave me a rubber hand, and it was the size of an adult hand, and the rubber hand had like red blood painted, like it had been amputated from somebody's body. And so I had a rubber hand, and I said, what can I do to get Rose? And so it was chilly that morning, so I had a long sleeve shirt on. So I pulled my hand inside of my sleeve, and I was holding the rubber hand. And so I walked in the office in the morning, and Rose was doing some paperwork. She was looking down, and I went by the paper cutter, and I started. And then I looked, and Rose still wasn't looking at me, and so I went. And I dropped the hand on the ground, and I started screaming, and Rose hurdled the desk. He said, what happened? What happened? Should I call the ambulance? What should I do? And then I started cracking up laughing. Rose was not amused. So every time the gospel comes up, if your hand causes you to sin, cut it off. I think about my prank on Rose. And how are we to take that? Are we to understand that literally? Does Jesus want us to amputate body parts that cause us to sin? If he did, I think we'd all be on the floor just rolling around blind. I think what Jesus is doing, he's using an exaggerated manner of speaking to make a point. Maybe what he's saying is, as important as your hands are, your relationship with God is more important. As important as your eyes, as important as your feet are, our relationship with God is more important. So if something is causing you to sin, cut the sin out. You know, don't cut the body part out. And so I was reflecting on that. Today's gospel, Jesus says, cut out the sins that you do with your eyes. And I thought about that for a while. How would we sin with our eyes? And the internet is a great place for information, a great place for research, finding out stuff. The internet provides a big temptation to look at stuff that we should not be looking at. Our eyes, Jesus says, if you look lustfully at another woman, you've already committed adultery with her in your heart. And I guess I presume the opposite is true as well. So our eyes, sins we commit with our hands, physical violence, obviously, we could be hitting somebody, punching somebody, sexual sins, cheating and stealing, and I don't know about you, driving on Ambassador Caffrey, I saw some hand signals that maybe were not pleasing to God. Sin with our feet, maybe we walked away from commitments, maybe we walked into situations that we shouldn't have. So I think what Jesus is saying, using an exaggerated manner of speaking, is cut out the sins that we do with those parts of our body. One of the sacraments that we have in our church is called the anointing of the sick. And it's in the book of James that we read about the anointing of the sick. And in James in chapter 5, we read this. Is anyone among you suffering? He should pray. Is anyone in good spirits? He should sing praise. Is anyone among you sick? He should summon the presbyters of the church. They should pray over him, anoint him with oil in the name of the Lord. And the prayer of faith will save the sick person. The Lord will raise him up. If he has committed any sins, he will be forgiven. And a number of times in this past week, people have called and said, my loved one looks like he's near death. Can you come and give the anointing of the sick? Sometimes people are having a serious surgery and they will ask me to give the anointing of the sick. And the anointing of the sick, the current version of it that we have, it anoints two parts of the body. It anoints the forehead and it anoints the hands. And this is the ritual book for the anointing of the sick. And so the anointing of the forehead, the priest prays, through this holy anointing, may the Lord in his love and mercy help you with the grace of the Holy Spirit. And then we anoint the hands. May the Lord who frees you from sin save you and raise you up. And so that's the current ritual for the anointing of the sick. I'm told that many years ago there was another kind of a version of it. And when the priest would celebrate the sacrament of the anointing of the sick, that he would, with holy oil, anoint all of the senses, all of the body. And I was able to locate the prayers for the previous version of the anointing of the sick. Listen to the prayers. The first one is the anointing of the eyes. Through this holy anointing, by his most tender mercy, may the Lord forgive you of all the evil you have done through the power of sight. And the next anointing is the ears. Through this holy anointing, by his most tender mercy, may the Lord forgive you all the evil you've done through the power of hearing. And the next one, the anointing of the nose. And I thought to myself, how can you sin with your nose? I guess maybe putting it in somebody else's business, maybe. Or maybe with illegal drugs, you know, snorting something with your nose. So here's the anointing of the nose. Through this holy anointing, by his tender mercy, may the Lord forgive you of all the evil you have done through your sense of smell. The next one is the anointing of the mouth. And through this holy anointing, by his most tender mercy, may the Lord forgive you of all the evil you have done through your sense of taste and through the power of speech. And the anointing of the hands comes next. Through this holy anointing, by his most tender mercy, may the Lord forgive all the evil you've done through your sense of touch. And then anointing of the feet. Through this holy anointing, by his most tender mercy, may the Lord forgive you all the evil you've done through your ability to walk. And I think that's a beautiful kind of a final act of contrition, if you will. That God, you have given me this body, and St. Paul calls our bodies temples of the Holy Spirit. And so sometimes we use these temples, these spiritual temples, in ways not pleasing to God. And so that anointing of the sick, the previous version of it, I think is a beautiful way to say, God, you know, anoint all of my body, and if I have used it in ways unpleasing to you, forgive me of my sins. So if I'm ever elected pope, we're going back to the previous version. If I'm elected pope, it's a sign of the apocalypse. So today's gospel, Jesus uses an exaggerated way of saying nothing should get in our relationship, in the way of our relationship with God. So Maybe before confession, would that be a good way to examine your conscience, to think about the different senses and to ask the question, you know, have I used these senses to glorify God? St. Paul says our bodies are God's temple, temples of the Holy Spirit. And so may, Lord, may we glorify you in our bodies.
Thank you.
fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. So with all the angels, we praise you, and in joyful celebration, we acclaim.
Thank you. graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you.
Weekend masses, weekday masses will be held in the Calais Center beginning on Monday, September 27th through Friday, October 1st. Our sanctuary floor is being refurbished due to the beetle damage. Our Holy Cross Knights of Columbus will hold their quarterly patriotic rosary on Tuesday, September 28th at 6 p.m. in church. It includes prayer, a patriotic song. All military veterans are invited and asked to wear their uniforms to this event, which is open to everyone. Holy Cross Catholic Church is celebrating our annual pet blessing on Saturday, October 2nd at 9:30 a.m. Please meet on the fire station side parking lot. Annual Animal Rescue Foundation of Louisiana is partnering with us this year and will bring adoptable pets. Respect Life Sunday is on October the 3rd, and our Holy Cross Knights of Columbus and the Pro-Life Committee are sponsoring a Respect Life Pro-Life Rosary. October the 5th at 6 p.m. in our prayer bar, which is located between the Mass office and Little Shepherd School. We welcome everyone. Our annual Mass of Hope and Thanksgiving for those afflicted by cancer will be held on Tuesday, October 12th at the 5:30 p.m. Mass. please sign up at the table in the back if you would like to bring baked cookies or to help that day. Thanks once again to the generosity of Holy Cross parishioners. Many items were collected for the Hurricane Ida supply drive, in addition to $32,000 in monetary donations. Thanks also to the many volunteers who worked the collection drive. For more information, please see our bulletin or visit our website.
To add to the list of craziness in 2020 and 2021, a family of Holy Cross donated our wooden floor. It's a walnut floor, and so they put it down, they varnished it, looking very beautiful. A couple of months after that, we noticed that there's little holes in the floor, and around the hole is sawdust. And so I think this cannot be good. So we did a little research, and we have some areas of what's called powder post beetles. And this is not the kind that sing and play music. So what's going to happen, the installer has to strip the floor of the finish, put pesticide down, and refinish the floor. So our weekday masses will be in the College Center. Our weekend will be in the church. I don't know what the condition of the floor next weekend will be, but we'll have a little portable altar on the side like we did when the floor was first going in. So hopefully that can go quickly. We don't have to do it too long. But you need to let it cure the finish for a while before you walk on it. So that's the latest of what's happening in the pandemic. Let's stand for the closing prayer. May this heavenly mystery, O Lord, restore us in mind and body, that we may be co-heirs in glory with Christ, to whose suffering we are united whenever we proclaim his death, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Lord, be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thanks be to God. St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Have a good week.